Hi, I'm Roger Braunstein, author of the ActionScript 3.0 Bible, second edition, and I'm going to show you how to run example code from the book online. It's effortless. When you're reading the book, you'll see a URL printed next to the name of every single example. If you're following along in the prologue, you'll see example 0-1 with the URL actionscriptbible.com/ch0/ex1. Go there, and it'll take you to this page. I've used the Wonderful service to host examples from the book. On the left is the code, and on the right is the output. Just click play to run the example. And that, my friends, is it. Since we're here, though, why don't I show you some of the unique features of Wonderful? Most of these buttons on the bottom are self-explanatory. Of particular interest, the download button below the code downloads a copy of the example. And the reload button reloads the Swift, running the code again from the top. Things get really interesting when you fork the example. Forking code is a way to play with examples, edit code in the browser, and share the results with the community. You'll have to be signed in to fork code, but you can use one of your existing accounts, so it only takes a second. I'm already signed into Google. Once I fork this example, I'm editing my own version of it. I've started off with the original example code here, and I'm free to take it anywhere. This is perfect for experimenting with something you've just learned from an example. Try plugging in different values, or combining the technique with other things you know how to do. The code saves and runs automatically. Just give it a second. If there's any errors in your code, the lines with errors will highlight. You can also see compiler output, including these warnings or errors below. Your creation will be shared with the global community. All forked versions of the original example appear toward the bottom of the example page. This way, everyone will get to see what you created with the example, and likewise, you'll benefit from the collective efforts of other readers around the world. Running and experimenting with examples online is easy, fast, and best of all, participatory. I really hope you learn from the book this way, and share what you learned with the community. Enjoy!